Hi everyone, welcome to Cosplayers React to Miraculous Ladybug. Today we're reacting to Chat Blanc, which is a really highly requested episode. I'm Rascal Rabbit, I cosplay Adrienne and Cat Noir for 86th Floor.
I'm Luminara, I cosplay Ladybug and Marinette.
And I'm Hilda Glitz, and I play Chloe.
This will involve spoilers, so if you haven't seen anything beforehand, go watch that, then come back to us.
At the time of recording this, it is currently the 6th of December 2019, so we don't know about anything that's happened after that date.
For those of you who've been requesting, I will be wearing the cardboard armour from Oblivio, that's the one. So yeah, thanks guys for requesting
that.
Thank you so much. I can't wait.
We hit not only 1,000 likes, but also 10,000, so there'll also be duct tape, there'll be cardboard, it's going to be brilliant.
Thanks guys.
I will get the Miraculous of Ladybug and Cat Noir, repair the mistakes of the past, and make sure you return to us.
Okay, so, right, I know we're, like, seconds in, but whenever an episode opens with Gabriel in his, like, lair with his dead wife in a box, you know it's going to be a good episode.
He doesn't like Boris, or
what
if he hates it when people celebrate his fifth
name's
day, or...
What is fifth's name?
Is it a French thing?
Yeah, can you explain what fifth's name's day is? Because we have no idea. I thought it was...
Who has a fifth name?
Adrienne.
Yeah,
how many names does he have?
I guess he's a posh boy.
He's a posh boy. He's probably got. What are his middle names?
Danger.
Adrienne Danger Aggress. But please let us know if you know what this is. We'll probably do a Google after this episode and realise what fools we've been. But please let us know because that would be good.
The only way you'll know is to tell him how you really feel. I know, but.
No food until you tell him how you feel.
I like us seeing this like powerful side of Rose though.
Yeah.
I like that she's like cute and has angel wings on her back and is like, you know, the epitome of like pastel and florally, but also like she'll tell you when.
She's had enough.
When she's had enough.
Rose is really over this.
She will
this.
Put her foot down.
To be honest, if I was in Marinette's friendship group, I think I'd be pretty over this as well.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Every time they hang out, it's like, oh, Marinette's going to ask Adrienne out. And
she's
it's
just
sort of
not
like,
there,
it's to a
is
point
she?
Where you're just sort of so like,
can I talk about like my problems now? Like, they do Rose, anything else?
Rose is there, like, me and Julika are literally getting married next week. Like, oh, why is the group chat still blowing up then, about Marinette asking Adrienne out?
And then Alia's like, maybe Marinette can ask Adrienne out at your wedding.
Today is the day. Go, 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 go.
God, this peer pressure. I'm getting a bit stressed out.
They've just had enough, like... Marinette's gonna get evicted from the friendship group and just not.
She's gonna get kicked from the group chat.
She's gonna get removed.
So, fun fact, Osh just reminded us, and you confirmed
Thank
it,
you.
That Rose's voice actress is the same one as Tiki's.
I think, anyway.
This is gonna be hilarious if we've gotten this wrong.
But I'm pretty sure. Sense. It's like how Max is Plague's voice actor.
You're kidding me.
I
did not know that. But that's because in my head, Plague's voice is Danny DeVito. While we're on the subject of voicing, this is slightly unrelated, but I'm a big Critical Role fan, and so therefore was absolutely blown away to find out that Matthew Mercer, the Dungeon Master from Critical Role, voices the spaghetti-obsessed photographer in this show, which just took me to another plane of existence.
It did take us out.
It really took me out by the kneecaps. That one did.
No, you heard what Rose said. I can't back out again. Since he's not back yet, I can go through the window. Oh, no.
Marinette. This is not how people's brains work.
Well, this is how Marinette's brain
Unless
works.
Unless you're Ladybug,
like,
suppose.
Oh, he's not in. I'm a break in.
like, even if you didn't have magical powers that could allow you to do that, why would you ever think that?
I feel like Marinette is the epitome of that one emoji that's just like... You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
She's Marinette. No, that's immoral. And she's just like,
what if I do it anyway?
The fact that she's there, like, I'm not gonna take no for an answer. Not a healthy way to go about anything.
That's
like,
not how you ask someone
that's
out.
That's really not how you ask someone out. Like, asking somebody out is scary because it comes with the, you know, there's two options. Either they say yes or they say no. And that's you have to be okay with that.
You can't remove the option.
Yeah, you have to be okay with them saying no and that they're not interested. You cannot just decide you're going to date them no matter what because that is really, really bad.
Good idea to use your powers for personal reasons. I'll be quick, Tiki. No one will ever know.
words spoken moments before disaster. I love the idea that Adrian saw that happen from his limo, like, in that same shot, and he's like, oh, Marinette okay. just ran through an alley and now Ladybug's just come out of the alleyway.
Oh, what could it
Where
mean?
Did Marinette go?
Like, well, they're such good friends. They're such close friends. Oh, God.
Sad. Will you let my father know I won? As soon as he's done with his work.
I love the horror chord that I
The background music is like...
I mean, we know she's a villain now, like, so I guess that makes
two
sense.
Two out of the three people who live in this house are supervillains, so...
This is true. And now, three out of three in this episode.
Oh, yeah. Ladybug? Why would Ladybug leave me a gift from Marinette? And with a heart embroidered on it?
That berry is a serve.
It's something else, isn't it?
I did straight up think that it was just like a folded up t-shirt, and he's like, oh, excellent. Another one of these. Another one that my dad designed.
I mean, I like it. It's quite cute because she's like taken his like brand and like, you know, she's
the one t-shirt he wears every day. Yeah.
But she's, you know, she's thought about his aesthetic, as it were.
Marinette asked her to. Or because Ladybug and Marinette are the same person.
Behold, Adrian Agreste.
You got it.
Grows a brain cell.
You know what's
wild is how out of character that is, because Plags actually told him, no, it's because Marinette and Ladybug know each other. And the Adrian we know would have been like, ah, yes, I see.
I see.
That's true, actually.
But now we've learned.
I remember when I first watched this, I was like,
huh?
I just, because yeah, you're right. Like everything... Every other episode, he really does just take the absolute simple route where he's given an answer and he goes, yeah, okay, that must be true. And you're just there like, oh, come on.
And I'd never want to lie to a friend.
But why do you think it would be lying?
Because there's this boy I...
Me.
You got it! He got it! I'm so happy so for him.
When you find out that so you are your own obstacle in romance.
Can we get like, a hell yeah?
It's like he's happy, but also like, oh no, this is also the worst thing.
What have I done?
Yeah, but then in a way, like, but that's what I love about this is that actually at the point where they do reveal themselves, like, it's kind of all becomes clear. It's like, oh okay, the reason we couldn't be together is because of you, but not anymore.
Okay, Adrian, this whole thing smells like rotten cheese. You know you aren't supposed to know each other's secret identities.
Just because I know her secret identity doesn't mean she has to know about mine.
Now it's all falling apart. It's all gone wrong now. Adrian, this is a problem now because now you're going to end up lying to her. And as we all know in this series, liars, not ideal.
I love how Plag instantly gives up.
Well, what are you going to do? He's just a boy in love.
Oh,
here we go. I do love Bunnix. It's a serve.
I thought that the reason she was like time travel themed was because like this is a bit of a stretch, you know, like the white rabbit in like Alice in Wonderland, yeah. Like with the clock.
I think that's it.
But then the snake Miraculous is also time travel themed.
Well,
so
I
that
think
just threw that all out.
Well, no, but isn't the snake? It's the snake is time travel in a different way because. No, well, the snake is a loop because you set a point in time that you can keep going back to. So it's the snake eating its own tail thing.
Oh,
whereas
right.
the rabbit, Miraculous, is much more like Doctor Who based. Yeah, hopping through time through rabbit holes. Like, all of that. Like, it's, yeah, it does make sense when you actually think about
it's
it.
It's very cute. I enjoy
Damn.
That.
That is so cool. Future Paris.
I want that episode.
That's really
Guys,
cool.
Guys, you know when we said let's do more AUs?
Oh, oh man. What if we did like...
What if they were
like
the
Tron
future?
Miraculous?
Just saying.
I don't know how we'd make that, but let us know if you'd want to see it.
Cat Noir.
M'lady? I thought I'd lost you.
And every Cat Noir cosplayer cries because we can't just palette swap our actual outfit because the wig is also different.
You know what? I'm very happy about the fact that they went with like blue eyes though.
Yeah.
Like originally people would like do, like the concept was purple eyes.
I think it's because that's like really... if you colour inverse it.
Yeah. But it's just alarming.
Also, purple is in keeping with the hawk moth colour scheme. Yeah. So yeah. Akuma wise, that makes sense.
It's just alarming though, isn't it?
The blue eyes are creepy. Like,
and also,
I do like it.
Like you get actual cats with that colour scheme.
Yeah.
As well.
Yeah.
You're back, and now that you're going to give me your miraculous.
I think we've talked about this several times, but when Ladybug and Cat Noir fight, it's
so good.
It's good, but it's sad and terrifying. Yeah.
It's just I like how this whole episode is supposed to be like quite unsettling. And
yeah,
like,
yeah. When we opened up on Oblivio and we were saying that had a real sort of like apocalyptic sort of horror movie-esque vibe, like there's a sense of unease. I'm like, what's going on here?
Yeah,
and like putting the pieces together a little bit that I think like.
I really enjoy
adds
that.
An element.
Yeah, because you have no idea what's going on. Obviously, as soon as he goes in for the miraculous, you're like, oh, he's been akumatized. Yeah. But like the fact that Paris is just completely obliterated and then this is the future, it's kind of like...
I love a bit of backwards chronology.
Yeah.
You need me to de-evilize you. Let me help you.
He's crying.
But he's also like crying over his mask, which I'm not sure is...
Oh, yeah.
You know, I think it's in Lady Wi-Fi where she tries to like pull it off. They are very like
they're fused,
they're thin, and they are like very against the skin. And like, because his eyes are closed there, and the mask is there. Like they move with the eyelids.
Yeah,
which as a cosplayer is a nightmare because our masks are a bit thicker. They're quite hard, and then they sort of end about here. So of course it probably does go outside because they're so stuck down.
Well, because the suits technically, yes, they're suits, but they're magical. Like they're part of the magic.
They don't
and
have
so
to worry
it makes
about
sense
like
that they're just
peeling
fused
it off
to
and, like,
their
ripping
eye.
Ripping his eyebrow and cosplay life.
Oh, damn. Yeah, I sort of briefly forgot that he
no,
knew
I didn't
who she was. And she doesn't know, obviously.
Alarming.
So that's a bit...
Oh, no. What have you done, Marinette? Ta-da! I did it!
Why has she suddenly got her hair down?
I think it is so it's obvious which timeline we're looking at.
Oh, that's actually a really good idea. Yeah.
She's feeling free and good about herself because now she's in a loving relationship.
She's a new woman.
She's let her hair down.
She's a new woman.
And it's so cute. It is very, very sweet.
So now we're in... Yeah, so the ones where she's got her hair down... This is the timeline that has gone wrong. This is the timeline that leads to Chat Blanc.
Yeah. It's cute,
it's
though.
It's really cute.
I do enjoy long hair.
I just wish I knew that, like, hair down Marinette was an option before I went about styling this.
So how did you get to Adrian?
I was very convincing.
Marinette, I have something to tell you.
This scene! Oh! It's so sad.
It's
when,
cute,
like,
but also like, surely you wouldn't do what he's about to do in front of all her friends. Like,
this is very true.
I've realized that you're not just a friend to me. I've always felt like you were more than that. And now I know why.
Us reacting on this episode.
Oh,
it's so cute.
God.
And I love you.
How cute! It's the same shot from Oblivio, but it's Marinette and Adrian this time.
Parallel.
I didn't think about that.
So cute! There we go.
Well, this is the thing. It's like so many wonderful things happen in Miraculous, but then it's just like,
but
reset.
Actually,
it's worse than I thought. Come on, Ladybug, quick.
Plot twist, Alex just doesn't ship them. Alex is like, I don't think you guys are very good for
this
each other.
This is my no TP. It can't happen.
Damn,
I can't
Alex.
Let it happen.
Why you gotta be a hater?
Give me your miraculous so I can make everything go back to the way it was.
That's a kamehameha. Was that from Dragon Ball?
Dragon Ball Z, yeah.
No.
Well, it is canon that Adrian does watch anime. If you're following all of the official character Instagram accounts, then there was a post on Adrian's account recently where he and Kagami were like studying Japanese together. He admitted in his description that he was like, oh, I already knew a few words, but it was mostly from anime. And I was like, yes.
I hadn't seen that. Oh,
it's
no.
It's really good.
Oh, Adrian.
It's such a little saga, actually, the little Instagram.
I do like the Instagram, I just didn't see that exact post.
It's really good. If you'd like us to do an episode where we react to the official Instagram accounts, then let us know, because that would be a really fun episode
to do.
Yeah,
that would be really fun.
We sort of go through and try and piece together the current plot line. It's really cool. Together. Yeah.
It's heartbreak for all the girls of Paris as supermodel Adrienne Agreste has. Hello!
Can we talk about this look?
What a
look! Oh, she's adorable.
When I first saw this, I thought that they were getting married and that they'd really time skip this.
They're getting married, but it's a goth wedding.
It's
a girlfriend. Miraculous Dupin Chang.
I mean, as cute as all of that is, it does kind of bother me that he knows she's Ladybug
and that
she doesn't know he's Cat Noir.
Yeah.
Which it does kind of, I don't know, it kind of like, it does put a little sour note on it because I'm like, but you're not being truthful with her. Like,
yeah.
And you did kind of only swap to liking Marinette because you found out she was Ladybug.
Yeah,
like,
right.
I don't know. I mean, obviously, they, like, according to this kind of little montage, they've been dating for like a while. So he clearly does like her. And I think that's the thing, you know, he does like Marinette. He's just so blinded by loving Ladybug that he doesn't think to give her the time of day.
But then he can have both when he finds
can have,
out.
He can have both, but I don't really like that he's being untruthful.
I know
with
what
her.
You mean.
I love the comedy in thinking about them having like a, you know, a going good relationship where he knows, but she doesn't know he knows. So she'll be like, oh, babe, I just gotta go and... and he'll be, like, totally oblivious. Like, there's so much comedy that could come out of that.
That's true, actually.
That'd
yeah.
be great.
They're on, like, a date at Miyakuma Hits, and she's like, oh, I gotta go to the bathroom. And he's like, no worries, I'll stay here. I'll hide under the table, don't you worry. Wink.
Oh, jeez, I hope that kind of stuff happens when the reveal actually happens.
And God, please. I'd love to see that. Well, the thing is that once the reveal happens and they both know, then it's not a problem because they're both like, as long as they both get away, they can kind of cover for each other. So for example, if they're at a party with their friends, they can be like, oh my god,
they take shifts
or like they work out like a code word for like, we've got to go, or you know, agents like, I've got to go and check on, I don't know, my dad who doesn't care about me, but I've got to go and check on someone, or Marinette does the same. I think it would be really fun to see them like try and keep the secret from everyone else they know now that they know themselves.
Question to throw out to the room. If you had to choose one of them to find out first, who would it be?
Ooh.
I like it when, I like the thought of of Marinette finding out that Adrienne is Cat Noir, because I think that throws more of a spanner in the works than Adrienne knowing Ladybug is Marinette, because as we've seen here, he just sort of goes, oh, well, I like Marinette too, so that's great. Whereas I think because Marinette's feelings towards Cat Noir is that, you know, she loves him a lot, but like as like a pal, and she finds him annoying, I think that would be more interesting for her to come to terms with, oh my god, this person that I idolize and crush on and have put up on a pedestal is also my super annoying pun making best mate.
Yeah.
How does she deal with that? And I think that's more interesting.
But I quite like the idea that Adrienne finds out first, so that then they have this scenario where they're together, and then Marinette finds out, and then she's like, it's like your perfect boyfriend, but he's Cat Noir. And then, so then her whole like image of Adrienne is just like, oh dear.
Yeah. Like, well, also the other thing is that I feel like as they get closer, like as they're dating, surely more of Adrienne's Cat Noir side would come out.
Right.
So she would, like Marinette might be sitting there going, God, he really reminds me of someone. He reminds me of Cat Noir, actually. That's a bit weird.
And then her just being like, wait.
If Ladybug starts showing affection towards Cat Noir, if that ever would happen, would be like, you're cheating on me.
It's a whole mess. This is why it's better that they just tell each other.
Miss Dupin Chang, your relationship. relationship with my son is detrimental to the Gabriel.
This scene.
This scene largely killed me.
So obviously this is supposed to be really sad because he's turning up and he's like basically breaking them up.
But then
he's doing it on an iPad.
He just comes in with the iPad like he's like, she's like a Teletubby.
But I didn't do anything.
She loves Adrian and Adrian loves her. You can't decide.
If you refuse, then he will never see his friends again.
Adrian does
not.
It's so sad.
What made for him?
It's so sad.
Why did you do that? Okay.
Get out of my bakery now.
Imagine being checked out of someone's bakery via iPad.
What annoys me so much about this is it leads to that like trope. Person A has to break up with person B because they've been told by an external force they have to. But instead
they
of,
don't actually
but
say.
But instead of saying, hey, I'm really sorry, I have to break up with you because this person has told me to, rather than they have to like make up this whole elaborate, like, I just don't love you anymore.
Yeah.
And it's just like, oh, it's so frustrating.
It does frustrate me because, yeah, you're so right. She could just be like, look, on the down low, your dad basically showed up at my doorstep on an iPad, no less, and told me to break up with you. So that's the sitch. We'll publicly break up, but we'll still keep seeing each other. Don't you worry.
Yeah.
Like, that could have solved this whole problem.
I mean, they're good enough at keeping secrets that they could keep it going.
Marinette, why won't you come in? What's wrong?
Adrian, forgive me, we're just...
The high drama of this scene.
This is the gate swinging open.
This is the closest it gets to like that like
Wuthering Heights energy.
Well, that sort of like sad dramatic French film.
Yeah.
That it's ever gonna get.
My relationship film.
I do not love you anymore.
What are you talking about? Of course we are. We love each other.
No, I don't love you.
A voice break. Oh man, shout out to Christina V for this performance because this is really good.
Oh, also, coming up, man, Bryce Papenbrook, like, the Adrian bit is so good.
Smashing it. Voice cast, you're doing a wonderful job.
It can't end at all. I love her.
Everything is going as planned.
Oh my god.
Just so savage. Utterly cold. Your son's been happy for once in his life. And you take it away from him.
I've never felt such utter despair. Marinette Du.
I mean, your wife's dead. I mean. That's gotta be.
I beg you, please.
I beg you.
We do stand the gorilla.
We do stand the gorilla.
Yeah, see, the gorilla is the one that I've always thought is the slightly sympathetic one. Like, honestly,
Natalie's a snake.
I could see him actually, like, knowing about it, but just not saying anything because, you know, like, he cares about this kid enough.
Can he
speak?
Has he ever spoken?
No.
He's grunted.
He's grumbled a bit.
I know that he's about to find out that his dad is Hawkmoth, but that did come from your own house.
Maybe Hawkmoth is their lodger.
He's Gabriel's roommate. You know, like in Lego Batman.
My roommate Hawkmoth. I know he's in an emotional state, but like running out of your house into the street, transforming where anyone can see you, but namely Marinette, who you've been lying to about your identity. It's just a whole lot. There's a whole lot going on.
Interesting. Mm.
You were about to be akumatized. I didn't have a choice, m'lady.
Aww. M'lady? But how did you know? I thought our identities were supposed to remain a secret.
Oh, it's so cute.
Aww. Marichat, but it's reciprocal.
Hey, aww. There you go. Also, shout out to Marinette for taking that quite well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's better than I would have taken it.
Yeah, I'd have been like, yo, what?
Everything will be okay, I promise.
Natalie.
It won't though, will it?
It cut to Natalie. About to end this whole man's career.
Natalie.
It's Adrian, your son.
It's Adrian.
To clarify,
your son.
Your son, you know,
tell.
Remember him?
But imagine the stress of having to tell your boss, who is also a supervillain, that his son is the superhero you've been fighting for months.
I love that she didn't miss a beat. She was like, yeah, he's Cat Noir. Got some news for you, mate.
Got some news. Like,
so yeah. Here's the tea.
So here's the tea.
Cat Noir, my own son?
Yes, send you my secret identity. Please respond. Right, so this is a really interesting scene because I have always been dying to know how Hawkmoth / Gabriel would find out, like, what A, would find out and B, react to this news.
Yeah, I don't like how he reacts to this. Yeah. I don't consider it the canon way
Roll
he would react.
Roll the tape.
The miraculous will soon be mine.
He's there like, oh my goodness, my son, who arguably I am doing all of this for to get my wife back and so we can have a complete family again, is Cat Noir.
I can brilliant. Use
this. I'm going to get them right. But I mean, part of me is like, yeah, okay, that is brilliant, because then he can go, Adrian, I know your identity. My identity is Hawkmoth. The reason I'm doing this is to bring your mother back. Will you help me?
Which, and to be fair, he does do, but it's very bad circumstances.
Bad idea.
It's all
yeah.
very
yeah.
quick and confusing, and he's a bit emotional.
Yeah.
All he needs to do is just sit down with his son and be
sit
like,
down,
right,
sit down, have a cup of
this
tea,
this is what's going
put
on,
some
mate.
Biscuits out.
Like, you know, this I need is what will help. Happen. I need your help here, mate. But talk that's not out. What he does.
Communicate.
Well, my wish would be to fix everything so we could be in love again.
You know what makes this more sinister? It's the fact that he's backing and forthing between, like, give me the miraculous, and, like, actually talking in quite a nice way.
Yeah, it's,
and it's
scary.
Very unsettling. Yeah. It's like, yeah.
It is spooky. It's just, it is
we
really
we love
spooky.
A hero turned villain.
Yeah.
This scene is probably one of the most, like heavy in oh, Miraculous. Yes. Yeah. Because like, Miraculous is usually pretty lighthearted, even when they're dealing with some kind of bigger oh, stuff. But this is, like...
I really enjoy how they do this. Like, I think it's really well done. Yeah. I wish it was a bit longer, and I wish it was, like,
yeah.
for real.
This could have been so cool as a two-parter episode.
Yeah.
Like, it is a shame that they had to fit all of this into 20 minutes, because yeah. this could have been a really cool
I'm
two-parter.
I'm still glad they did it. No one says that.
Who
says that?
Things I love about the scene is, well, first of all, I wish we had seen like the lead up to this moment, but also Adrian and Marinette are fighting as Ladybug and Cat Noir, knowing each other's identity,
yeah!
which makes them stronger.
That's so cute.
It's really good.
Adrian.
How do you, mother?
I'm doing it for her, Adrian. For you. For us.
Christine! So much!
This is, oh.
Ow.
Why?
Like, what is Hawkmoth's motivation here? Like, he wants to, like, bring back his dead wife so that him and Adrian are, like, and her can be, like, a happy family. And here he is just punting Adrian. Just kicks Cat Noir into the stratosphere. That's your son. That's your son.
Was.
Not only talk about insult to injury. Kicked him into the atmosphere and then like punts him away. It's just really not
baseball
it, is it?
Bat. Why are you doing this? Like, I genuinely do not understand his motivation here.
I think he's just getting a bit carried away.
They just wanted a bigger a bigger area to fight. And
yeah.
The easiest way to do that is just to throw character A.
Yeah.
And then everyone else follows.
Just yeet him away. If Hawkmoth really loved Adrian, he wouldn't have yeeted him through the window, would he?
This is
the thought.
Like blackmail, man.
How awkward would it have been if Cat Noir just fell on the tarmac and died there?
Broke his spine. Died.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, he'd be like, oh,
Adrian.
This is a bit awkward now. I don't
Adrian.
Need to do this anymore.
Oh.
Oh, well. I guess I'll take your miraculous anyway. I guess we'll add you to the resurrection list. So he gets a wish, right? From the two miraculouses together. What if instead of the wish being bring Emily back to life at this point in time, his wish is actually go back to the point in which she died and changed the... You know, we don't know how she presumably died due to an incident with the Peacock Miraculous, right? Mm-hmm. So maybe he's like, actually just reset us to that point before she dies and then we're not going to do that thing. So he's probably... Yeah. Yeah, you're right. He's probably thinking like none of this... Will matter. Yeah. It doesn't really matter how I treat anyone.
It doesn't matter if I baseball bat my son into the sky.
That's why he says in the beginning, we can, I don't know if it says reverse the effects of the past, but like fix the mistakes of the past or something like that in the beginning. Like,
yeah. And that's probably out of the, it's probably out of the abilities of the rabbit miraculous.
Yeah.
If he even knows about the rabbit miraculous and what it can do. So, you know, he needs the two most powerful, which are the ladybug and the cat one, because... You know, together, like, it's life and destruction, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's
like
luck and destruction. And together, they can presumably do anything. I think also this scene just makes me go, damn, Gabriel, you are really beyond redemption. Like, there is nothing here.
Gabriel, where your morals at?
Gone.
I'm sorry,
this is genuinely
very sad.
Don't worry, Gabriel.
That was difficult to watch, man. That's sad.
That really got me the first time, man. Like,
same. I was. I think I was like literally biting my nails in front of the TV. Like,
how dare you? Not me, Adrian.
What were you expecting?
Not me.
This was so hard to watch. And like, oh my god.
That's my son. My boy. Oh man.
Yeah, so man. Sad. Like, he's just feeling so many things.
My prince!
Why'd you call him that?
No, but that's got to be like a he calls her princess thing.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah.
Is it cute?
But why does she call him my prince? Canonically, Chloe is a better hero than Adrian because she was able to resist the Akuma.
Okay, but Adrian is going through a lot here.
Yeah, like, he is.
So much has happened in the last like 30 seconds of Adrian's life.
Yeah, whatever. Let me have this
one. Kimmy's a nap.
I know this is
boy blows up the moon.
I know this is supposed to be tragic, but it is quite funny.
I know the moon is pretty big, right? But what are the chances that it hit the moon? Like, boy messed up big time.
Osh just made a good point. Hawkmoth's dead. Like, he died. So how is he still akumed? Also, how is he still alive? Because he broke the moon, so therefore, like, all of the water levels would be everywhere.
Well, I mean, the water levels are everywhere.
Oh, of course, yeah.
What's wrong?
This is really sad because when I first saw this, I sort of thought that as soon as she devolized, like everything would just disappear around her and she'd end up back in her usual time and like it would just fix everything. But the fact that then she's created there's an alternate timeline version of Adrian who's been through all of that, who knows her identity, who knows his dad's identity, and she just has to leave him to just be, I guess, lost perish to the void of time.
Wow, thanks for that.
Yeah.
It's really sad. It's like the whole like cloning thing, because like you have like the Cat Noir in this timeline and then like the other one. This is the whole thing like with I don't know, it's like weird because then you just stop existing and it's
yeah, I guess it's not really dying because you just cease to exist.
That's so weird.
Deep.
That's the same thing with like Timebreaker.
No, but it was different in Timebreaker. Ladybug had split herself onto two different timelines. She was going in a loop rather than, because there's two types of time travel, right? Bunny Miraculous versus the Snake Miraculous.
Right.
Hopping through different points in time, things will split off into different timelines, which means that everyone has died in this timeline. What point was I trying to make? Oh yeah, in Timebreaker, set loop that they were going round in is fused back into her own conscious, so he doesn't really exist. He's not gonna go back to being Adrian, is he? Does that make sense?
Sure.
Yeah.
I know who you are, Minibug, and a few other things too. Do you know who Hawkmoth is? Even if I did, I couldn't tell you. That's the reason you picked me, Minibug. I know how to keep a secret.
That sort of implies that at some point Alex is going to know something. Whoa, because she goes, yeah, that's why you picked me. And obviously she has not picked Alex yet. Like, there's been no episode where she's given modern day Alex the Bunny Miraculous. Yeah. So it makes me think either there's some event that's going to happen in the future where she has to tell Alex who she is, or Alex proves herself in some way, yeah, that she doesn't, or she finds out by accident who Marinette is and she totally keeps her word. And so then eventually Marinette's like, I know the perfect person for the role.
So what was that sudden call for?
I did it.
Huh? I have no idea what you're talking about, but I'm perfectly fine with it.
I killed an alternate version of you.
It's really sweet. I love stuff where it's like one character has had an experience that makes them realize how much the other means to them.
Yeah.
Like,
look how happy he is too.
He's so happy.
Yeah. In contrast to earlier, he looks
look
like
at that.
The sky, man.
This is where, like, some of those really pretty pictures from the picnic CMV.
Oh, yeah, yeah, always. It's like the picnic
also,
CMV.
Powerful sky.
That's so cute!
I love them so much.
Oh my god, what an episode.
Whoa.
I did just whoa.
Whoa. My brain hurts after the whole, like, time travel thing, but now it makes a lot more sense to me.
I feel very clever now. Yeah. Someone's going to tell me I'm wrong, but if I am wrong, please let me know, because I feel very smug.
It's one of those episodes that kind of hurts. Like,
yeah.
I do feel a bit, like, things get fixed, but I do feel a bit, like, melancholy seeing, like, all of the things that could have been that were really sad.
It does make you feel a little bit better, because you really want Adrian and Marinette to get together, but then you see in this episode what would actually happen if that happened.
So actually, that kind of bothers me, because so much of season 3 has been really cementing how much they shouldn't be together and how much they shouldn't reveal their identities. Like, there have been so many episodes where it's proven to be a bad idea. Mm. And that kind of sucks. Like, I, like, you know, I obviously really want them to be together and I want them to reveal themselves, because that's sort of, it's what you've been hoping for the whole way through. And so to have a lot of the narrative say, nope, they can't be together. Like, Tiki and Plagg multiple times have sort of said, if you reveal each other, then you have to give up your Miraculous. It kind of is sad, because it doesn't have to be this way. Like, it doesn't have to go like
it's
this.
It's a bit heavy, isn't it? Or maybe, you know, all they're showing every possible way that it could go wrong, so then when they actually do get together, it will be perfect and amazing. And it's lovely that we have, like, a fan theory coming canon again, like, I know Chat Blanc was a very, like, sort of a bit of a self-indulgent headcanon. It's like, oh, he was evil, but then it was like
it made him for a good episode.
But I like that this is a show where that actually happens quite a lot. Like, they do sort of take a lot of opinions from the people viewing it.
They listen to what we want.
Like, Kwame Swap, back in the day, that was just, you know, fan art, like, that was all over the place and everyone had their own idea of it. But we were like, it's never going to be real, lads. And now we have it. So, like, I do like that, like, a lot of people's sort of, you know, creative visions as fans have actually, like, come to light.
Thank you so much for requesting this episode. It was very highly requested, and I'm so glad that we've got a chance to react to it, because it was really good. Let us know if there's any more episodes that you'd like us to react to. I do read all of your comments, and you've been leaving some amazing ones, some great theories, some great stuff that you just thought was funny, requests for episodes. So let us know what episodes you'd like us to do next, because we will definitely pay attention.
Don't forget to like, comment, hit the bell button, and subscribe.
Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.
Bye.